routine business right downtown Myrtle Beach, basically. This is the Pavilion. It's supposedly the largest park here as far as entertainment parks, a roller coaster and everything. They've got water slides here, all kinds of entertainment for kids and stuff.
We were here for the last weekend, I can tell.
This park right here, this water park, Magic Mountain and everything, is right adjacent to the campgrounds where we're staying, which is not open right now. And then down here just a little ways, there's a, it's like, I guess, an amusement park of some sort. It's Magic Harbor, and it's, I don't know, kind of back inside here. This is a Magic Mountain. It's like a water slide and everything. And then right, as you can see, right down here is the Pirate Land Campground. And there's the entrance to it. So this Magic Mountain is just right outside the camp entrance. Pretty large complex. All along the streets, they've got these little signs and stuff that light up at nighttime. I don't know whether you'll be able to see them on this video or not, but there's like anchors and seashells and
mermaids
and a little bit of everything. You see them on the light poles coming down through here. Business is about a block off of the oceanfront, and all the motels and hotels are on the oceanfront, and on 17 businesses, all your shops and everything. Alright, this is the Carolina Opera House. There's two different theaters on this location, and the other theater is this Dixieland Stampede. Dixie Stampede dinner attraction. We're going to go to this Tuesday night. It's like a Western style dinner and everything with a Western show. Again, this one's called the Dixie Stampede. It's a dinner show type of a thing. You can see that arch up there in the picture or not, up there on the road, but that arch is for bungee jumping. Right, this is the Alabama Theater. It's in North Myrtle Beach. They have shows here nightly also. We don't think we're going to come to this one at all. They do have shows here nightly. And across the way here is what they call barefoot landings. There's about 100 shops or so, restaurants and stuff, novelty shops, souvenirs, things of that nature. We'll get a better shot of it here in a minute as we're going out. Okay, this is the Barefoot Landings here. All kinds of shops and everything. All back in here. Cross bridge that goes from one part of the complex to the other. We've got several restaurants that are on the water. Very nice shopping center, basically. We was here all day Saturday. There's an RV camp too, right across from this Barefoot Landings. Barefoot RV resort on the ocean. Dad, this shot's for you. You're gonna like this. This is the Waterway Hills Golf Club. Very unique because the only way you can get from the parking lot, which I'm standing in, to the golf course is by way of an overhead tram system. It goes across to the other side to the clubhouse and the golf course. That's the golf course over there. Now, the reason they need the overhead tram is because the overhead tram takes you right over top of the intercoastal waterway. So the only way you can get to the golf course, like I said, is load your clubs and everything in the tram, and it takes you over the intercoastal waterway from the parking lot to the clubhouse. Got some guys over here teeing off. Can't tell where they're going to, but... Well, looks like we've got some golfers that were through for the day. As you can see, they're coming back from the clubhouse, coming back over to the parking lot. And both cars just crossed. As you can see, a very unique way of getting from the parking lot to the clubhouse. Pretty short trip, doesn't take too long. This golf course is located up on North Myrtle Beach, up on Highway 17. This was one of the most unique ones I think I'd seen. Well, looks like he's just about arrived at his destination, so we'll take off and go see what else we can find. into Myrtle's Inlet for the day's fishing out the Gulf Stream. These are some of the homes out on the points and some of the fancier homes on the island. A little inlet. Looking back to the north, it's pretty windy out today. That's Myrtle Beach up there to the north. A lot of motels and everything on the beach. Another fishing pier up here a ways. Everybody fishing off the pier here. Back up to the north toward Myrtle Beach from the fishing pier. Pier catching, I guess what they call it, Virginia spots. I don't know, it must be like a trout or something. Thank you. Well, we've arrived at the indoor pool. This is leading up to it here. It's a little outbuilding called Pirate's Cove. I guess it's like an outbuilding you can rent. As you can see, a lot of these are permanent type fixtures. He's had a little wrecked golf cart.
I don't take nothing.
Our in-law had a motorhome. We're down here with it. We're kind of scoping out some place that we think they would enjoy coming and spending some time.
Yeah.
Are you a permanent resident?
Yeah.
Just another one of the small lakes here in the campground. And this little one over here kind of leads out right out to the ocean. This is the outdoor chapel here in the campground. Right down here at the end of the road is the ocean. You see that gazebo thing there? It leads right out to the ocean there. As you can see, it's a really, really super clean park. They really keep it up. It's really nice. Basically how far we were, you can see this little gazebo here. This is just how far we had to walk to get to the ocean, which wasn't very far, probably about 50 yards or so. high tide right now. You have some people in the water.